I am a doctor. I have zero training in art, and I don't really think I even have much ability in art, but I think I have a decent eye. But art is something that I think is so close to medicine, and medicine and art keep bumping up against each other. And my father was also a child psychiatrist studying autism. He had heart attacks in his 40s, and he went to rehab when he was, you know, basically a young guy in his 40s. And he met another young guy there. And that young guy is David Lester. David was in his 30s because he's significantly younger than my father. And they maintained a friendship that is now what has really allowed Bold Beauty Project to blossom. So I think there's such an irony in that my father's, you know, quote unquote disability or different ability is what's really helped launch the Bold Beauty Project, even though my intent was to help my daughter because of her health issue. So you never really know where life is going to lead you and how, you know, things seem to be separate, you know, art and medicine, how they're going to overlap and how they're going to come together. But what I've learned is we can't stay in our silos, and that we have to merge. And as artists, we need to come together, and we have to help the medical community. And as a medical community, we have to come together, and we have to use the transformative power of art. I recall myself when I went through a divorce and was very, very sad. One of the things that helped me through it was a painting of Versailles. And I would just lie in bed and I would just look at that painting. And that would be like a little thread, like a little hope to the future. And so I think the healing power of art is something that we as a medical community need to embrace more.